So for that part of the demo, I'm going to show how to control the saber using the USB port. This is done currently using the USB serial port here, but it's also available on the auxiliary serial port, also formally known as the RISE port or the TTL serial port. So basically you can choose which one you're using. The USB is of course very convenient to talk to it from the computer because you don't need any adapter. The auxiliary serial port can be used to connect to Omnisabers, but can be used also to talk to another peripheral or to talk to a regular RISE port using a stereo jack. RISE would work just the same. So what I'm going to do at the same time is recording my screen. I have docklight open on the serial port, and as you can see, debug is activated. To have a full log of what has been happening on the saber, you can see that it's very verbose from the very beginning of the boot. You have all the blade profiles going there, all the color profiles that were red, the tangible information, the custom OLED string that can be displayed as well. All the files found in the font, which is looked up, and it will tell you if there is any problem or if certain features are available or not available based on the type of files that they found, that it finds. You have all the color profiles and blade profiles that you want to use or skip, the smooth swing parameters. You have all the accent LEDs configuration. I will make a dedicated video about the accent LEDs because the new sequencer is definitely crazy in terms of possibility. And then you have all the pictures that got loaded and so on. So fast forward to where I am in the log, and I have a bunch of text commands that are here that I can use to start the saber. I can double that as many times as I want. Far off, far on, give a crash, turn on the lockup, turn off the lockup, start the track, far off, far on, stop the track. You can also move to another font, versus shadow point. And then you're back in business with another font in real time. And you can do power off, power on, I'm asking to play fire right now that isn't there because there is no local tracks on that font, but so there you go, all the things that you can do to remote control the sabers. Those are just a few of the basic commands that you can send to the saber. You can trigger the blasters, you can trigger the lockup, whatever. You can do a lot of things. I wanted to show that also all the actions or events are logged, as you can see on the screen. You have the file that it's trying to play, which clash sound has been selected. Basically what happens when you start the lockup, when it stops the lockup, power off, and like I said, pretty much any decision that is taken on the board regarding the movement, the color profile, the selections, all of those are obviously exported if the debug mode has been selected. So there you go. I'm going to show some of the details regarding the interaction between the user action and the sound and the OLED display. So basically, like I demonstrated previously, you have a close interaction between some of the actions, the sounds, the user interface sounds, and what is displayed on the OLED display. So I wanted to show that, for instance, for the blade removal. You have a customized bitmap that is displayed each time you insert or remove the blade. Of course, those are configurable, like I explained before. Everything is stored on the SD card, the sounds and the pictures. And so now, basically, if you try to start the saber,
primary crystal missing.
You get more user interface sound.
Primary crystal missing. Primary crystal missing.
So, it's one of the possibilities that you can have with the combination of the OLED. Rob McCall did a wonderful job on those fonts description, graphic description. Those are stored in the font folder. This one is static, but like I showed, you can have some animated ones. There you get the crystal and the force sensing. So now I'm going to use the breadboard to demonstrate what happens in case of low power and to show what happens on the PLI as well. Obviously, I would like to demonstrate that directly on the saber itself, but it will make my life very difficult to change the voltage as everything is installed with the batteries, and I cannot deplete the batteries like magic. Sorry about that. So quick move to the breadboard. Breadboard magic! Here we are. So I wanted to show a couple of things, like I said, in the PLI real-time changing. So I'm currently powered by a power supply unit so that I can change easily the voltage. And as you can see, I'm now showing a variant of the PLI that is a sort of a printed circuit board and on which you can see the bars that are changing in real time. It's really responsive. You can even get a blinking LED when you're really on low power. And basically when you reach this, which is like below 10%, how many dots do we have? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. So yeah, when you reach that final dot, you're below 10%. And you get a message, vocal message, that you are basically having low energy.
So, energy critical.
So it's not preventing you to start, hence you just shut the display off like any other animations. When you power off, the display goes off, at least for now. Basically, if I remove the blade, you still have this, it goes power off. I reinsert the blade and check my PLI. Sorry, I went too fast. And still low power. It stops. You got another message right there that can be combined with the low power. It's the high temperature. So the system measures the temperature and will report if you are above a certain threshold that is configured again in the configuration file. You can decide to have that very low so that you have the simulation of over temperature of your crystal, or you can put it very high if you don't want to use it. So it can be an actual use of it, basically props that work, like I say. If you want to monitor that your saber is not going too hot because you're using sensitive batteries, or if you're pulling a lot of current out of the batteries, you can monitor exactly what is going on inside the hilt and put basically a threshold of, 45 to 50 degrees would be a reasonable threshold to look at. If it goes above this, be notified that something is going wrong. So I went below. I went below the level of my cells, which are described in the PLI thresholds on the SD card and the configuration file. So basically, if I go below 1% of the PLI range, then I will have I will be forbidden to start the saber, and you get the message and the animation.
Sir,
on the
energy critical.
Sorry.
Focus path temperature critical.
I was not low enough. I'm going to show that again. So there you go. You have both problems shown, and you have the associated sound for the missing diatom cell, which is pretty cool. Focus path temperature critical. I'm going to blow on the sensor just a little bit to cool it. I get only the issue. You can see that the temperature went back above the level, as well as the PLI voltage. So, as you can see, PLI voltage is now above 10%, and I'm authorized to start the board. Focus path temperature critical. But the temperature is still very critical. So, like I explained in the other part of the video, all the sounds and pictures and pretty much all the resources are configurable on the SD card, and you can customize that to whatever you want. All you need is just a drawing program like Paint. I'm using PaintShop Pro for most of my job, but you can use also icon editors, since those pictures are only 128 by 32 pixels on the display. It can be done with a lot of different tools. So there you go for the OLED display and PLI configurations. Hope you enjoyed the video, and talk to you soon on the forums and on Facebook. Bye.